So some years ago, I ran into an Excel problem at work, which I couldn't solve. I had Excel 2010, even though it was 2014. To give you some context, here's the task I had to do. We had a new reporting structure, the master data we had for products was changing, and I had to assess how that would impact our numbers and if we should go ahead and make the changes in our financial system or not. Here's a simplified version of what I was trying to achieve. I got this file extract from the system. It's sales data by transaction, product quantity, and some other fields. It had 1.2 million rows. I knew Excel could handle a lot of rows, so I copied it over to Excel, but unfortunately, I got this error. I went ahead anyhow, and then this came up. No choice but go with OK. I got my data in, but it's not all there. It got cut off. This means I had to find the last row that got imported in the text file and then copy and paste the rest manually in.
A few moments later.
So I ended up with my data on two tabs. Okay, so far so good. I also copied over the product master data on two separate tabs. So the new master data has a different allocation of product code for department and section. What I needed to do was to create a report showing total quantity for the new department setup and compare that to the old department setup. I rolled up my sleeves and I started writing VLOOKUPs. My plan was this. I would add new columns to the sales sheets for department old and section old, then another one for department new and another one for section new. With the VLOOKUP formulas, I could bring over the corresponding department for each row. Once I finished that for part one, I had to repeat everything for part two. Then I created my first pivot table based on part one data. I put department new in the rows and quantity in the values. I repeated that for part two data. And then I created a report that added the values from the two pivot tables together. So this gave me the breakdown of quantity based on the new master data. Now, because we wanted to compare this report to the old master data, I had to repeat the process. Create two pivot tables based on the old master data, and then a report that adds the values together.
Approximately 10 hours later.
It took some time. I had to do a lot of double checking because I wasn't sure if I'd made a mistake during the process since a lot of steps were involved. I showed the report to my manager and they were happy with the outcome. But, because there's always a but, they also asked for a breakdown by year. And the manager of the electronics department wanted to get a year-to-date view of their data as well. I was so close to saying it's not possible because it felt like an impossible task, but I kept my frustrations to myself and I spent many hours trying to do this. But that wasn't the end of the request because then the next department wanted to see their numbers and compare it to the previous period as well. Of course, all of this took hours and at the time, so remember this was 2014, no one expected it to be fast anyway. But if you use this approach today, so the same approach that I used a few years back, then you're probably going to be seen as slow and inefficient. Because if you're dealing with a lot of data from different places, then you need to take advantage of the power side of Excel. If you don't, it shows that you don't have the skills that are needed today. So now let's take a look at how you'd solve this today. Plus, I'm also going to show you how you can easily get the breakdown by year and do year-to-date calculations or any type of calculations that you might need on this data. First thing you'd do is upload the data to the data model, which you can do through Power Query. Instead of writing formulas, you'll create relationships. Once the relationships are set up, you can insert a pivot table and have access to each separate table. The relationships act like VLOOKUPs between the tables. This makes it very easy for us to analyze quantity based on the new master data. Or we can create another pivot table based on the old master data. So you have both views side by side. And if we want, we can analyze both, so old and new, in the same pivot table. We can create a matrix and see how everything fits in. Now notice the numbers have no formatting, So you'd have to format these every time you add them into a new pivot table. So if you're planning to reuse a value in the values field, like I'm reusing the quantity field, then you'd be smart to create a measure. This way, the number formatting is embedded in the value. It stays with it. Every time you bring it to a new pivot table, the formatting is there. Also, sometimes you have more complex calculations. So for example, you want to calculate total quantity for products that were on sale. In our data set, this means on sale has a value of 1. You can do this calculation with a simple measure that looks like this. Instead of adding separate columns to your data set, you'd add measures. These measures get automatically calculated after you drop them in your pivot table, so they don't increase the size of your data model. So as you can see, doing the first comparison, new and old master data, is so much easier this way than the old way. Another alternative would be to merge the data in Power Query. But Power Query has its limitations too. It's going to be difficult and inefficient to do time intelligence analysis in a single table. So the better way of breaking down the data by year and doing year-to-date reporting or calculating moving averages or running totals is to use the data model and DAX. And here's how easy it is. Go to the data model, to design, date table, new. This will automatically create a calendar table for you with a bunch of columns like year, month, month and year combination, weekday, week number, and so on. Now you just have to go and create a relationship between your sales table and this calendar table. Then go ahead and insert a pivot table. Bring year to columns, department based on the new master data to the rows, and quantity to the values. That's it. What about the year-to-date calculation? Just go to measures, new measure, call it YTD quantity, and type in total YTD. The expression is our total quantity measure. And then we just need the date column from the calendar table. Adjust the number formatting and add this to your model. Now, let's move these around. Add year and month to the rows, bring department to the filters. Add the year-to-date quantity to values. We can filter for any department. So it was the electronics department that wanted to check their year-to-date data. Let's filter for them. Check this out. The sum of this equals this number. What if we have different fiscal periods? It's no problem. Just update the function. Add in quotation marks the last day of the period. So here I'm going to add 6/30 for June 30th. Click on OK, and your year-to-date values reset in July. It's that easy to get more complex insights from our data. There are many simple formulas like these you can use in DAX and the data model. The great part is that data modeling in DAX is not just for Excel, but it's also a skill that you need to have for Power BI. So you learn one feature, and you can apply it to two different apps. In fact, these are the two most used applications at companies today. Here's the thing though, DAX can get quite complex. And if you see the complex side first, you might be discouraged to learn it. At least that was the case for me. But the reality is that there is so much you can achieve with just a little bit of DAX knowledge. Within 1 hour, you can create a complete interactive sales dashboard that brings data together from different files. In fact, this is one of the first dashboards that we create from scratch in the basic section of my Power Pivot and DAX course, which, by the way, is now open for enrollment. There's a link below the video if you want to find out more about the course to see if it's for you. So what it comes down to is that you have standard Excel on the one side and Power Excel on the other side. Both of these exist in the same Excel application. It's easy for us to stay in our comfort zones, but the ones who use the Power side will be more efficient and they're going to be able to create better quality reports in a short period of time. Now, some might call them lazy, but smart. Let me just give you some more ideas about what you can do with DAX and the data model. You can create reports that show 10-day running totals or moving average, average daily sales. You can get the total sales value of your top three products. Find out which date had the highest sales or which product brought in the most revenue. You can do time intelligence calculations on custom calendars like weekly calendars. All of these topics and a lot more is covered in my comprehensive Power Pivot and DAX course. In fact, it's three courses in one. We start with essentials, then move on to master difficult DAX concepts, and we create dashboards along the way. This way, you don't just learn these concepts in isolation, but you learn how to integrate them with standard Excel. You also get a lot of challenges and find a mistake type of exercises, which will help you learn better and remember better. So come join me in my course and master the power side of Excel.